in Brackenville. Four of them got the Medal of Honor back in the day. So that was big time, yeah. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people don't know about the Fort Duncan Club or the barracks. All the way down at the end of this road here, it burnt down in the 1990s, okay? Mm-hmm. And this is a picture of the barracks back in the day, okay?
That's that building up front, right?
Yeah, the one that's burnt down, okay, with the historical marker. Now, one of the very first Army aircraft flew from Laredo to Eagle Pass. And here's a picture of the aircraft, and it's parked in front of that building, okay, right here. This plane here, another picture. But they didn't call it an airplane or an aircraft. It was known as a one heavier than air. It was a flying machine, and it was one of Wilbur and Orville Wright's planes. Came here in 1911, landed and parked out in front of the barracks down there, which is awesome history. Awesome history. Now right here, this is Richard Duncan. Says murdered at Eagle Pass. Actually, he was found guilty. He killed a family of four, a mother, a husband, and the two little girls. So he was found guilty, and he was hung in our old jailhouse. Now the sheriff sold tickets. If you bought a ticket, you got to go watch the hanging. I mean, people would come in their lawn chairs, sit out there, little picnic and everything. That was just a big thing back then. Didn't have much going on. And after they hung him, the sheriff took the rope down, cut into a bunch of little pedacillos, and passed them out at the little schoolhouse. All the kids at the end of a little piece of rope. Ah, it was different times back then. Wow. Different times back then. Now Robert E. Lee, he did come here to Fort Duncan as a colonel back in the day, so he did stay here on Fort Duncan.
That's Robert E. Lee.
That's him. Now kids, what do y'all know about, okay, the parents, don't say nothing, I know y'all know. What do y'all know about Ignacio Anaya? Ignacio, very famous guy. You from Eagle Pass, you don't know? Does mom know? I take it back. He was from Piedras Negras. Ay, menos. Okay. All right. Ignacio Anaya. Okay, back in the 50s, right across the bridge, he had a place called the Victory Club. Okay, La Victoria, the Victory Club. Okay? Ignacio Anaya worked there. And his nickname, I'll give you a hint, his nickname was Nacho.
Is that why they have the nachos?
So Los Nachos being added right there from the Victory Club. A lot of people thought it was from the Moderno. No, it started at the Victory Club, then he had his own place, Nacho's Place, y luego the Moderno.
Oh, but yeah. I remember the Moderno.
But yeah, that's where they started, yeah, right there. Well, I'm sure you already knew that, right? Yeah.
No.
And of course, you know, we've had tons of floods, okay?
Yeah.
Of course, this was before we had Amistad Dam in Del Rio, one year after Falcon. But like we had this one here, like 1919. Here's some of the soldiers, World War I. We had 1932 and the 20th. I mean, 54 was the main one. There's Bridge 1, here's Main Street. You're looking at the library, depot, and it actually was going up Main Street. Mm. And it came in just that fast. The day that it came, my dad worked at JCPenney's, and he was downtown working at JCPenney's, and he saw a guy outside with a piece of chalk marking on the side of the building. He says, if you don't mind me asking, what are you doing? He said, tonight the water's going to be right here. And my dad's like, look, the sunshine. He said, are you crazy? So, but that night, the water was right there. And my dad had to swim up because he lived right there on the Oasis Street. But the water came up so fast, and back then they didn't have amber alerts and no way to really inform people. So at first, they had thought maybe 500 people had died in Piedras. Because they had already gone to bed, y luego when the water came, ya subieron todo, they couldn't get out of the house, so they were drowning. But I heard stories from my parents would tell that they would get on the roofs, but they'd be on the roofs and they would see little canastas floating by with little babies in it, because they figured they were going to die, so give the baby a chance, maybe someone would find the baby. There's some babies floating by, it was just really,
wow.
Yeah.
Devastating.
Yeah. But of course now we had have Amistad Dam in Del Rio. Of course that went in 1969. But then we have, it said, 38 dead, 90 missing. But that's no telling how many weren't reported or how many. There's no telling.
Wow.
Yeah, major floods.
You wouldn't believe it if they just told you. With the newspaper, you kind of.
Yeah, it's just like, You see that? And it just really brings a realization of what's going on. Okay, this is my Native American room. Now, back in the day, we had, of course, the Kickapoo, we had the Comanche, and the Lipan Apache. Most of the stuff in here is Kickapoo. And I do have the Lipan Apache, the colorful prints right here. And the man up here, that's Chief Papiquano. Okay.
Now,
Kickapoo. Mm-hmm. Now, the very last war chief they had was Chief George Whitewater. It was right here, Whitewater, who he was actually a World War II paratrooper. You see him up here, but right here it shows him, World War II paratrooper, again there. But he was so, they said, so flaquito, so skinny that they had to put weights on him, because when he jumped out of the airplane, he would blow off course. So they had to put pesas so he would come straight down with his parachute. Yeah. And look at this. Show them on the back of this outfit right here. Y'all come look. On the very top of the shoulder, go in there and tell me what you see. The very, mero arriba, right on top of the shoulder, right about this area right there. It's a two-tone blue. Mm-hmm. Once people see it, they go, ay, Dios mío, because it's a swastika. But I tell them, who came first, the Native American or Hitler? Of course, Native American. And to them, it meant peace, love, and compassion. Now, Hitler got it, and he inverted it. Of course, we know what he did with that.
Yes.
Yeah, not a very good thing. Yeah, 1976, when I was in the military, I went to Munich. Outside Munich, went to Dachau concentration camp. And that was just horrifying, just realization of just how many people were actually, you know, murdered there. And it was just, was not very good. Let me see. I'm sure y'all have heard of a rain stick, right? Y'all heard of a rain stick?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You heard the rain stick before?
Mm-hmm.
You want to hear it again? It's kind of cool. Yeah. The other day I had it out and I had three or four little kids over here and I did it. And their little eyes got this big and they're like, Yontalawa. They were like, where is? Okay. Your eyes got kind of big too.
So realistic.
Isn't that awesome? But I had like 80 kids one day and they were, you could hear a pin drop. And their little eyes, I see, just they were just, they were even touching me. El agua, junta el agua.
What is that sound like? What's inside?
It could be little beads. It could be semillas going down different little baffles. But it's used in their ceremonies.
What, the
Kickapoo? No. This is just Native American.
Native American.
Yeah. No. I wish it was, but no. This is just Native American. Most everything I can say in here is Kickapoo. I've had a few stuff. Well, actually, I I had two of the spoons donated by one of the Kickapoo donated those. And y'all know what these things are?
He's like, are those for Chile?
Well. Okay, well, over there, okay, that's, you're used to those. That's from molcajete, okay? These here are metates.
For the corn, right?
For the corn. It could be for anything, chile, anything. Just crush them up. Of course, they put them in the bowl, but yes, the metate. But aren't you so happy that you didn't live back then? Because you'd be, I see, making the corn. Then you'd have to wash the clothes. I see, on the piedras. Oh, that would not be good. You got it made now. And then the planchas were so heavy. We like, kids got it made nowadays, huh? Yeah.
So I'm recording this already, so I'll cut in.
Okay, great. Yeah. And of course, that's a picture, that's their holy land, and it's Nacimiento over there in Coahuila. Now, I'm sorry, y'all know what symbol that is over there, that star? Most people would say that was the Star of David. But to the Native American, that meant equality. Because no matter how or where you turn that star, it's all, see what? It's the same. It's equality. And when I was growing up, this is the way it looked like under Bridge 1 where Shelby Park is now, okay?
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. Because I left in 1975, and this was actually taken a year later. This was 1976. Because you can see it's got, that's like a 73. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. When I left, that's the way it looked. And these are called wiki-ups, and that's for the Kickapoo.
I remember the wiki.
Yeah, I used to work at HEB downtown, and I would see the people taking the carton, and I didn't really realize, I had never been over there to see it, that they was for, oh, they're taking it for their houses. I had no idea what they were. Yeah, very naive. Do you know what that's used for?
Houses.
Yeah, it's like a big molca head there. You put like dried venison, bison meat, buffalo meat, semillas, lo que sea, and then just crush it up in. And I imagine too, you might get a little bit of piece of wood in there too. It'd be good for your digestion, I guess. A little roughage, you know. Just I don't know. Now this picture right here, this is a very early George Whitewater, and he's next to Chief Chacuca Anico.
Oh, Anicos.
Mm-hmm.
This is over in Muskies, right? Or in Oklahoma?
No, this is, I believe, right, Nacimiento over there, yeah.
Nacimiento.
Uh-huh. All right, guys. What is that right there?
A taco.
It has its own Facebook page, okay? I'm serious. That is the Eagle Pass Taco has its own Facebook page. He's been to see the chief of police, the mayor. He's been everywhere. Yeah. It's just a little gimmick we have, and we take it all over the place. Kind of neat.
The sun?
I thought it was the sun, but then I saw, hey, well, that's tomate, and hey, that's queso. Excuse me. You do too much talking in.
Need some water.
I need to. There we go, okay. Ay. Oh, and I'm going to show them a trick in a little while. I don't want you to film it because then I'll give away my little trick. But several years ago, I went to a funeral, and when I came out the back door there at Barreras, Jaeger's, I saw this ashtray. The Sunny said it was outside, and I said, man, that looks familiar, you know, because I have a pretty good photographic memory. If I see something, I remember. So I went inside and asked Mr. Barrera, oh, ese que está quebrado, pues, yeah, because it's just an old one. It's an old ashtray. So I brought it back. And then I started going through my pictures, and this is a picture of the old First National Bank downtown. And here's your Sunny Settles, okay? Okay. Now, this is Melrose, okay, downtown. So once this bank closed, okay, it moved to First National Catty Corner from the Aztec. Then the ashtrays went over here, okay? This is the lobby of the Eagle Hotel. You came in the front door. That's the Sunny Settles right there. So it's just like, wow. But it's like I know I've seen that thing someplace before. And it just
right there?
Yeah. But that was the lobby of the Hotel League. Beautiful. I mean, they had the chandeliers were wagon wheels, cavalry stirrups with the lights, 30-30s, muskets. They had the furniture was cowhide with wagon wheels. Beautiful. And they tore it down. And guess what they built? You'll never guess. Beautiful hotel came down, and guess what they built? A parking lot.
Oh my
God. A parking lot. Naranjas, nothing. I'm like, whoa. But yeah, and one thing about Eagle Pass, back in the day, they tore down a bunch of old, beautiful buildings like that, ornate, because they figured it was old. They wanted, to them, modern was like straight brick, casicum, straight glass, that was modern. They had no idea what, you know. With this beautiful stuff. And I mean, this building still exists. It's there on Main Street, more or less across from the Riskins. You can go, of course, all this has changed, but you can still see those. They filled all this in with bricks. So you can go over there and you can look at it and you can see all brick, but you can see the three arches still. It's still there. Yeah.
That's what they're doing right now. They're kind of, Joe is
He's trying to, trying to get that taken care of. Yeah, that's nice. They had just taken the facade off this one here, where you can actually see the 1892 whatever and the 1914 where they made the renovation. But pretty cool.
Eagle Pass history.
A lot of history. A lot of history. Okay, now y'all know where Bibb Street is, right? Bibb Drive? Mm-hmm. Okay, that was my uncle. That was Theo Roberto. Uncle Bob. There's Uncle Bob. He was Judge Bibb. That was my abuelita, Lula Bibb Hart. That was my grandma's brother.
County Judge R. E.
Bibb. Yeah, and he was good friends with, of course, JFK and LBJ. So LBJ was always down around Eagle Pass. Fishing, hunting, shooting quail, whatever. He was always down here. It was pretty neat. Pretty neat. And since you're recording, I have other stories, but I have to tell those in person.
Yeah, no, that's fine.
Yeah. Let me see.
What did you get new? Well, I know you had all this here.
Okay. How many swords did I have when you were here last time?
Tell you what.
Swords?
Let me see them. Give me a quick. Oh, you didn't have that many.
Okay. I don't know if I had this showcase. I bought this showcase. I bought a couple in the front there.
Yeah, it wasn't here.
Yeah. Now, I'm going to take some swords out, and y'all get to hold swords, okay? But just don't sword fight, okay? Man, it's amazing. The other day, I handed this little kid a sword. Little kid, you hand it to him, and he was just like, no, give him back the sword. He was looking at his, come here. Yeah. No. Yeah. That's just what's sad. All the games they had, they don't realize that these things are actually. This is an 1830s. This is Toledo, España, Spain. Spain sword. So.
Spain sword.
España. Look at that. See, she. Okay. Now this one here. This is a 1914 U.S. cavalry sword. And. Don't think you get to squeak up, Mom. I've got to give you one too here. If I can get this one. This one's a sharp one here. Oh, I got it. You never grab it from here because you might get cut. But this is a 1903, 1904 Russian cavalry sword.
Russian cavalry.
Russian, Why don't y'all get together? Let me take a picture of y'all.
Okay.
You get together and kind of cross your swords like y'all are going to be sword fighting or something. Okay, let me see here. Okay. Look this way. Uno, open your eyes. Dos, y, right. Fort Duncan Museum page. So have y'all ever held a sword before?
No.
Okay, I'm gonna see how. Let me see here. Let me see your sword. Okay. What, and you can put yours here too. Where I'm gonna ask y'all a question, see what you see. Okay, what difference do you see between these two blades and this blade? Besides the color or whatever.
The numbers.
Well, you notice it has this little groove right here?
Mm-hmm.
This has a little groove también. This one, at least, this has nothing, okay?
Is this homemade, maybe?
No. This is a lot older.